Pokemon Ultimate Adventures by Mike Azuki. Chapter 15. The Power of One Shines On. When I first defeated Doppelganger, I felt that time that all our troubles were over and we could move on. I had no idea how wrong I was that time, as it had the complete opposite effect, attracting even more trouble than ever before. It was naive of me to think that just by getting stronger, I could make it all go away. Though it certainly has helped, because the level of my opponents seemed to keep rising. At this moment, all of my Pokémon are nearing level 100, and yet it still doesn't seem to matter to my opponents, because they've attained levels that go beyond the limits of Pokémon trainers. Still, I'll find a way to beat them, no matter how strong they are, because I was soon to discover something even more amazing than the Unistrike or the Kaiser Beasts, or anything of the sort. My own power. Ash Ketchum. Location: Missingno Gang HQ.
Ah!
Ash gasped, seeing the hooded figure.
You!
It sure has been a while, Doppelganger smiled wickedly. Hasn't it, Ketchum?
Ha!
Before anyone could move, Ash roared and dove forward, pouncing on Doppelganger and slamming him to the ground.
What?
He exclaimed, when Doppelganger shattered to pieces.
You keep falling for the same trick, idiot!
Another Doppelganger laughed. It was unclear if he was the real one either. He stood some distance from Ash.
No, I'm not gonna fight you yet. I just came to remind these people where their loyalties lie.
He eyed the rest of the gang.
And to personally invite Ketchum and my former comrades to come meet the boss. As for you, Ketchum, he scowled, we have a score to settle.
And with that, he shattered to pieces. Another copy. We thought his ability was cool at first, but when it comes down to it, he's a one-trick pony, Bonsai scoffed.
However, that invitation does sound interesting.
And I'm not opposed to the idea of trashing Faker again. Ash cracked his knuckles.
But it doesn't look like they're about to let us through, he commented. They're not even worth your time, Ash.
Brock stepped forward.
You go on ahead and deal with the boss. We'll handle things here.
You guys are good, but not that good. You won't be able to handle these numbers, said Bonsai, and turned to Cleft.
You, stay here and fight with them.
What? Why do I have to stay and fight the garbage?
Cleft exclaimed, while the whole lot of punks scowled at the remark, being referred to as garbage.
This is the leader and doppelganger we're dealing with. It's not just gonna be the same as the usual trash. Plus, with your injuries, I don't think you're exactly ready to fight the tough guys just yet, said Bonsai.
Yeah, right. Even in this state, I could take you on.
Oh, yeah, right. What are you gonna do, beat me up with a crutch?
Watch it, grass boy. Speaking of which, you haven't been smoking any, have you? It'd explain how you actually got the idea you're stronger than me. Skyrender warned you to quit, but you being the plant expert, it wouldn't be that hard for you to get your little green fingers on the stuff.
Hey, I may specialize in grass, but I don't smoke it!
Bonsai snapped at him, but then paused. At least not anymore, he added guiltily. And at that statement, Cleft looked at him in disbelief, and then burst out laughing.
Let's go, Ketchum,
said Bonsai, grabbing Ash and pulling him by the arm.
Your friends will be fine.
He looked back, seeing Cleft was swearing loudly and smashing his fists left and right, sending gang members flying everywhere, while Ash's friends started attacking again. There was a door leading outside of this room, and Bonsai kicked it open, and they ran through.
And a quick word of warning. I'd better not hear any jokes, hippie remarks, or anything of the sort regarding my old habits, because I will not hesitate to kill over it.
Wouldn't be the first time. Understand? He added in a threatening voice. Whatever. Ash's mind seemed to be elsewhere. As the two of them continued running through a filthy hallway, they could see another door coming up quickly.
Whatever we may face, I'm taking on the Faker.
Ash spoke in a serious tone. Still holding a grudge, eh? Bonsai stared at him.
Well, that's fine with me.
Let's go!
One, two, three!
The two of them shouted and tackled the door, bursting right through it and running into the room inside. Ash, Pikachu, and Bonsai looked around. It was a wide room with high ceilings, and there were stacks of crates everywhere, meaning this place must have been used as a storage area at one point. Bonsai looked at the crates. Frankly, I wouldn't be surprised if these things were filled with drugs. Just running around and mugging random people doesn't bring in that much income.
That door was unlocked, you know,
a voice spoke up. Ash and Bonsai moved forward and saw two figures. One of them was Doppelganger, the other a larger person, sitting on top of a crate. Dressed in a black outfit, his hair was dyed in flaming red color, and he had a fiery pattern tattooed from his shoulder down to his elbow. Wrapped around his forearm was a chain. This was the leader of the Missingno gang.
So, we meet again, Jackknife, said Bonsai, staring at him.
You're the leader of the Missingno gang, said Ash.
This man, he was in his mid-20s, and he didn't really seem like the warrior type. However, Ash could sense it. This man was strong.
You're Ash Ketchum, right?
Jackknife looked at Ash.
I've heard a lot about you. Believe me, my little brother won't shut up about it.
He turned to Doppelganger.
You two are related?
Ash said, somewhat surprised.
Well, there's one screwed up family.
At that remark, Doppelganger lunged at Ash, but Jackknife grabbed him.
That's right, we're brothers. And I also happen to be a lot stronger, he replied, ignoring Ash's statement. I didn't have any interest in being a super fiend, and I was especially glad when we broke off connections.
But now?
Just what are you doing, showing up like this? Come to give me a goodbye kiss?
He added mockingly.
You know exactly what I came for, Bonsai said, taking a fighting stance. You were said to be the strongest punk to ever walk this town, and I want to see just how strong. So, you came to fight me for that? He laughed. Fine then, I'll accept your challenge.
Slowly, he got up. From out of nowhere, he pulled out a dangerous-looking combat knife and spun it skillfully between his fingers.
Ha!
Ash gasped. Before he knew what had happened, Jackknife had darted forward and nearly slashed Bonsai. Bonsai, however, had deflected the blade with a folded iron war fan.
He's good,
was the first thought to cross his mind.
Hiya!
Jackknife roared, swinging his other hand and punching Bonsai across the face, causing the fiend to stumble back a few steps.
Hiya!
He moved forward, swinging aggressively, forcing the fiend back.
Hiya!
When Bonsai blocked the knife, Jack had kicked against his shin and swung his blade at his neck. Bonsai gritted his teeth and moved his head, evading a lethal swing. Quickly, he jumped back, putting some distance between him and his opponent. Bonsai could feel a sharp pain on his neck. The knife had grazed him.
Fast! More than that, skilled too!
He placed his hand over the cut. Any deeper, and it would have hit a vital spot. I'd bleed to death. A smile crossed his face.
You are good. Don't underestimate me, super fiend!
Jackknife spat.